an hour, 30 kilometers an hour, school zone, pedestrian crosswalk. Yes, for drivers out there, you will no doubt be familiar with the dozens and dozens of injunctions that you are exhorted to adhere to every minute of every day that you are on the roads. And of course it's that way. Why shouldn't it be that way? I'm sure if we are all being honest with ourselves, we can all attest to those times in our life when on the road we have resorted to four-letter colorful words to describe the actions of the car in front of us that happens to be turning too slowly when we'd like to continue straight through the intersection, or any other number of events that happen on the road every single day that tend to piss us off, to not put too fine a point on it. Myself, as well as I'm sure everyone who's listening who is a driver, has had experiences like that. But what if I was to tell you that it is not the green lights, red lights, and other traffic signage and exhortations that actually keep order on the streets, but the exact opposite? What if I was to frame it this way? Whatever comes between you and the green light that is about to turn into a red light is not a human being, is not someone with a story that you care about going somewhere for any number of reasons, just like yourself trying to get from point A to point B, but is immediately and thereby a human obstacle. And all other considerations of that person's humanity go out the window because they are no longer a human, they are an obstacle. So, let's keep that idea in mind for a moment and examine an interesting article that was recently posted by a Corporate Report listener in the Netherlands, Tor Valberg, on his site updatetoday.net, where he asked the rhetorical question, what happens when the traffic lights go out? Talking about the recent power outage in Amsterdam that resulted in, yes, many traffic intersections in Amsterdam being without the governance of traffic lights. What resulted from this? Chaos on the streets, rampage, people dead, all sorts of accidents? Well, no, as Tor Valberg notes and was surprised to discover himself, actually people didn't turn into marauding, crusading, crazy maniacs trying to kill as many people as they possibly could on the streets. After some period of confusion, people simply deferred to what would be the natural rules, one would think, in such a situation, allowing people right of way when they appear at the intersection first, taking turns. That's a sort of natural human action that arises in those types of moments where suddenly there are no laws, rules, regulations per se bounding our rules of interaction, but suddenly we have to treat other people as human beings rather than human obstacles. It sounds like a crazy, ridiculous idea, but in fact it's a well-documented phenomenon known as spontaneous order, and spontaneous order is actually something that comes from the economic sphere. This has been talked about by various economists over the centuries, but I think it applies to all types of social and human interaction, not just those of the economic variety. So I'm going to be writing more about this idea, generally speaking, of spontaneous order in this weekend's International Forecaster newsletter. I hope you'll tune in for that. I think it should be interesting. But let's just continue on talking about the roads for a moment, because again, this idea of spontaneous order on the roads is counterintuitive, but demonstrable. There is evidence to talk about what we're seeing here. For example, those of you who have not seen the pair of YouTube videos called Roads Unfit for People and Roads Fit for People are highly encouraged to take a look at them. They are incredible examples of that type of spontaneous order that arises not from the intricate detail and description and proscription of exactly what has to happen on each road each and every time, but simply by letting people act as natural human beings toward one another. Again, this sounds like crazy theory, but if you actually look, there was, for example, just as one example of many of such examples that have been tried out, in Portishead at the cab stand junction, which is one of the most heavily trafficked junctions in that area, and in which traffic lights were put up several years ago and created a lot of havoc and chaos. The Equality Streets group, headed up by Martin Cassini, came along to try just a trial. Let's just see what happens if we take the traffic lights out. And for people who haven't seen those videos, please don't go see it, because again, seeing is believing. It is incredible the phenomenon that happened there, where they took the traffic lights out, and not only did it not cause chaos and blood and rampage on the streets, it actually caused more traffic to flow through that junction on a daily basis, resulting in 50% reduced commute times for the commuters who use that junction, and not a single accident or injury during the time of the trial, after which the Portishead Town Council decided to make it a permanent move. They took out the traffic light altogether. Now, I'm not saying that what we should do is go and take out all traffic lights from everywhere and all regulations on the road overnight. People have to be conditioned into seeing other people as human beings equally as much as we've been conditioned our entire lives into seeing other people as obstacles who are only bounded by laws, regulations, authorities, and police. But it is a huge transition that has to take place, but it is one that is possible. Once again, the concept is spontaneous order. I have more to say about that in my newsletter coming up this weekend. Take a look for it.